students, today we will be discussing about the anatomy of the testis along with the intact epididymis and the spermatic cord. So here you can see this is the testis, and this testis is homologous to the ovary in a female. Testis are two in number, one is the right and one is the left, and the left testis is considered to be lower to the compared to the right testis. The testis is suspended in the scrotum by a cord which is called the spermatic cord. So now it is important for us to identify the side of the testis, whether it belongs to the left side or the right side. So let us talk about the structure of the testis. Now here you can see this is the upper pole of the testis and this is the lower pole of the testis. In anatomical position, the upper pole is directed medially and forwards. But how should I decide whether this is the upper pole or this is the upper pole? Now the first point you should note here about this structure. The structure you are seeing here, this is the epididymis. This is the head of the epididymis, and this head of epididymis is in contact with the upper pole of the testis. So when we see the head of the epididymis, we decide that this is the upper pole of the testis and this is the lower pole of the testis. What are the other parts of the epididymis? The head, the body, and lower down here you can see the tail of the epididymis. This tail of epididymis, it terminates as the ductus deferens and continues up into the spermatic cord. Now this membrane you can see here is the covering of the testis, which is called the tunica vaginalis. If I remove the tunica vaginalis, the covering which is sticking to the surface of the testis is the tunica albuginea. Now, after deciding the upper pole and the lower pole of the testis, I would like to tell you about the borders and the surfaces of the testis. The testis has two borders. This is the anterior border and this is the posterior border. Now, if I want to decide which is the posterior border, I see the attachment of the epididymis. The epididymis is related to the lateral surface of the posterior border. It means this is the posterior border and this is the anterior border. So I will place the upper pole upwards, anterior border anteriorly, and then I come to the surfaces. This is the lateral surface and this is the medial surface. I look for the sinus of epididymis. Now you can see here there's a space between the epididymis and the testis. This is called the sinus of epididymis, and this sinus of epididymis is related to the lateral surface of the posterior border. So this, which the side where you can visualize the sinus of epididymis, it is the lateral surface, and the other one is the medial surface where you cannot see the sinus of epididymis. So now if I keep these features in mind, the upper pole which is in contact with the head of the epididymis, the posterior border which is related to the epididymis, the lateral surface from where I can visualize the sinus of epididymis, I can decide that this testis belongs to the left side. Now, about the spermatic cord. Now, you can see here that the spermatic cord is attached to the upper pole of the testis. There are three coverings of the spermatic cord. They are the external spermatic fascia, premastric fascia, and the internal spermatic fascia. The external spermatic fascia is derived from the external oblique muscle of the abdomen. Next to it is the cremastric fascia along with some strands of the cremaster muscle, which is derived mainly from the internal oblique muscle of the abdomen and a little bit of contribution from the transverse abdominis muscle. The internal spermatic fascia is derived from the fascia transversalis. Now coming to the contents of the spermatic cord. The contents of the spermatic cord, one I have already told you, is the vas deferens. The other structures which are present within the spermatic cord are the cremastric artery, the testicular artery, the artery to ductus deferens, the pampiniform plexus of veins, and the autonomic nerves. So students, this is about the left testis. Now just to revise the site determination, you can see here, this is the right testis. Now if we compare both of them, you can see here the upper pole is close to the head of the epididymis as here. This is the lateral part of the posterior border. This is the posterior border of the right testis. This is the anterior border of the right testis. The lateral surface of the right testis, you can see, you can visualize the sinus of epididymis. So this is the medial surface. This is the lateral surface and this is the medial surface. The anterior border, this is the posterior border, this is the upper pole and this is the lower pole and this is the spermatic cord. This is the epididymis, the head, the body, the tail, which continues up as the vas deferens of the right side. Thank you very much. This was all about the testes.